So guys, 80% of your certification is about select query, because there are a lot of things that you can do with Oracle select query. Now, all other queries are very simple. They have pretty defined functions. So in the DML commands, we have only completed the select query. Now let us look at insert, update, delete, merge queries quickly, and then we'll be getting into DDL commands as well. Now the insert query, we have three variants of the insert query. So in one insert query, what you can do is you can define the column names in which you are inserting the values. The another variation of the insert query is you do not say the column names, but you just give the values that you want to insert. And the third one is by using a subquery. So you can insert into the table name by selecting some value from a different table. All right. So let us look at this command in depth. Now, before I get into the inserting values, if you remember, we have different types of data. I'm not talking about the data type. Let's get generic. So we have numbers and all others. There are basically two types of data that we can divide. We have numbers so that we can perform numeric functions, and we have all other type of data, right? Whether it is character, date, or whatever type of data that you want to specify. In this case, the numbers, the value inside a number column, a column that takes number values, in this case, you do not specify single quotes. But if there is any other column, whether it is character or other varchar or varchar 2, in that case, or if it is a date column, then you specify single quotes and then put the value. That's how you input the values inside the table. Now in this case, you see hr.regions, that's the table name we are trying to insert. So the command is insert into hr.regions values. This values keyword, after values keyword, you have to specify the data that will go inside the table. Now in this case, the values that you specify, it has to be as per the structure of the table. So what does that mean? So describe hr.regions. Let us run this query. Now do you see, we have the first column as region ID and the second column as region name. The first column, if you see the type, it can take a number value, and that's the reason you have to specify in the same order in which the columns are already defined inside the database. So you cannot put or give the value something like this. After this, you specify 10. This will be a problem for the database, because database will try to, or Oracle will try to insert this value into the first column of the table, which is accepting only number value. Okay. So in this kind of scenario, make sure when you specify the values, you are going by the column names, how they are defined inside the table. So the first column is region ID. In this case, when you're inserting the value before the comma, all the column values are separated by comma. So when I say 10, this 10 will be inserted under region ID. After comma, we are jumping onto the second column, and under the second column, Great Britain will be inserted. That's the region name. Now, if you want to insert a null value, rather, let's take you don't want to specify the region name, then you can just type null. Okay, you have to type null. And if you see this column null, it will actually tell you whether you can insert a null value inside a column or not. The region ID, because it's a primary key, we already know that region ID will be a primary key. It's a not null, column. So any column that is defined as primary key, by default it will be a not null column. You cannot insert a null value inside a primary key column. But in region name, we see that there is no constraint or there is no rule of not null. That means we can insert a null value under the region name. All right. So that's why we have 13 as the region ID, because we cannot keep the region ID null. We see not null, but we can definitely put a null value for the region name. If you specify or give a value something like this, insert into hr.regions values null comma London, this will throw an error because you are trying to force a blank value in a column that is defined as not null. Perfect. That's the first variation of insert command where you directly insert the values. But we also have another variation of insert command where you can specify the exact column name in which you want to insert the value. Now this is the perfect example. Can you see insert into hr.regions? Now the values that you specify over here will be inserted into the table in the order in which you define the columns over here. Now the first value that we are passing over here is Australia, right? Now Australia will be going into region name column, and this 11 will go under region ID column, because we have specified the order of columns in our query. Now, if you specify the order of columns in your query, it doesn't matter the order of columns in the actual database table. In this case, you see region ID is first, region name is second, but over here we are reversing the columns. We are giving the region name first and region ID later. So this kind of query will succeed, because we are defining the order of the columns as to how the values are to be inserted inside the table. And if you want to insert value only to one single column, like in this case, we are inserting only under region ID and the value we are giving as 12. So what happens is the region name will be by default a null value. Unlike our previous query, you see over here, we have to specify null value. In this case, if you do not specify values for other columns, all other columns will have a null value. Again, it depends if you can insert null value or not. Now, inserting rows from another table, let's take you want to insert values or rows from another table. It's very simple. Use a subquery. Insert into regions copy. Let's take we have a table called as regions copy. You select star from hr.regions. So all the records from the hr.regions will be selected and inserted into this new table, right? So one important thing, guys, I want to mention it right now before I forget that. All numbers must be direct input. Any other column must have single quotes. Like for example, if you want to input the name John, it will go like this. If you want to input the current date, then it will be what? 01 December 2018. That's how you have to input. So any value that you want to insert inside the table, apart from numbers, it has to go inside single quotes.